With torrential rain pouring into already swollen rivers, an urgent warning.
Don't hold back, don't stay there, don't say that the floodwaters never reached, you know, your house last time. This may see more people needing to be evacuated. People need to be on alert and on alert right now.
A huge area stretching from the state's mid-north to south coast is on high alert. In Western Sydney, there are major flood and evacuation warnings in place for areas around the Hawkesbury, Nepean and Georges Rivers.
Of course, all of our attention is on Warragamba Dam, which spilled in the early hours of this morning. And at this stage, we are expecting something similar to March of 2021.
Sydney residents told to make urgent preparations, including tying down trampolines and sandbagging.
Where we're standing now, I'd say by tonight, it'll be under.
Further north, Ballina's floodwaters have peaked, but the town's lost power and communication lines.
We still have a large number of helicopters up north that are helping and around the Ballina area particularly. And we've got troops on the ground as well to help in some of the messaging. So we are actively door knocking.
While in Lismore, residents are returning home to utter devastation.
Everything's gone. We've got three kids. Everything's gone.
We've spent 23 months putting this together myself. And I have to see it get pulled apart piece by piece like a jigsaw puzzle. It was just devastating.
As new stories of heroism emerge.
Stuart brought his boat down and he rescued 20-odd people. He had to go and unscrew a roof to get some people out through the roof.
A lady out of a tree.
A 73-year-old woman was clinging to a tree.
We saw a couple of boats came up and it was just like people screaming. Like, you realise they're not even on the roof.
Rescue crews now facing the grim task of recovering those who weren't so lucky.
As the floods recede, we are going to see more tragedy. And it's been an incredibly difficult time. These are unprecedented floods.
82-year-old country music singer Marge Graham and 84-year-old Lorraine Hyman today named among the victims.
This is terrible. I mean, this is terrible. One life lost is one too many, but these are communities that have been impacted, these are families, these are loved ones that have been impacted by these losses.
Chris Barth is in Lismore where it has just started raining again. You are in the CBD, Chris. What's happening there?
Well, thankfully, the rain has actually just stopped. Fortuitously for Lismore, it was a brief storm. It looks like Casino copped the worst of it. Lismore got off lightly because rain's about the last thing this place needs. This is the first time that a lot of business owners in the CBD have been able to get into their places of business today, and you can hear the alarm going off in the background there. That's just, there's all sorts of extraneous noise coming out of this place. They've had almost no power most of the time. But when you talk to business owners here, it flooded in 2017. So they were ready for this. They put everything, all their goods, as high as they could because they thought that the flood level wouldn't be past the 74 level or the 2017 level. But this flood was at least 2 metres above that level. Wow. So people here are in absolute disbelief. A lot of them have said after 2017, a lot of businesses didn't survive. And now the ones that did were just starting to breathe. Aww. They said they've survived the pandemic and now this. And a lot of them are in total disbelief that this has happened again and they're wondering how on earth they're going to survive. I wish I could bring you better news.
Well, people are starting the cleanup now. How is everyone coping?
Look, it's quite extraordinary. We haven't been able to get into all of Lismore today. There were still rescues going on. It shows you the scale of this. But the people that we spoke to are mostly grateful for the community effort. They say without the community effort, many of them wouldn't have their lives. They say the community pitched in boats and rescued them. And there's been this extraordinary thing with many people that we've spoken today. Many of them were stuck on their roofs. We spoke to Wally, a homeowner in South Lismore, and he was on his roof with his two kids under five and his wife. He's a first home buyer. He bought the house because it was above the 74 flood level. So there he is sitting on his roof, the first flood Wally's ever been through, and he's looking at his elderly neighbours. A boat comes to rescue them. He said, no, get them first. They're worse off than me. People across the road said exactly the same thing. A jet ski came to rescue them. They said, get our elderly neighbour. She's worse off than us. So the extraordinary thing here is the amount of selflessness in the community, even though so many people were in fear for their lives. So I think that's what's getting a lot of people through here. People are really helping each other, and the houses that we've been past today, they're helping each other with the cleanup as well. So the community spirit in Lismore has been absolutely extraordinary in the face of all of this.
All right, look after yourself, Chris. We'll leave it there. Thank you so much for your time.